Good morning, everybody. I'm happy to have a brief time to give a bit of insight, deeper insight on how the Philippines use SWIFT. So you've seen in the opening speech by Alain some tremendous growth in traffic all across markets. So what we can do a deeper dive to give you some more precise information on how you use that traffic. So I will give a few key indicators, just a handful. It's interesting for you to know you can also do that yourself. I come back to that. Okay, so in fact, first thing, for all that growth you saw there in payments, exactly what are the top five counterparty countries that are used for payments going out of the Philippines? I'm talking both about the wholesale and the customer payments. Well, the top five, in fact, quite a surprising lion's share. The first country that the payments go to is the United States, almost 70%. Right? And then there is also very big, there is Germany, China, and Hong Kong, also quite big. So because of the large focus, you could say, on payments going immediately into the United States, and it's not really a surprise, because if you would look at the currencies, most of the payments that leave the Philippines are in USD. So let's have a closer look now. Where do those payments actually end up in the end? Okay. In fact, it turns out from those payments that go, like the 70% of payments that leave the Philippines, that go to the United States, roughly half of them stay in America. And also sizable numbers go to China and Hong Kong. So if you think on the previous slide, while the US seems like an enormous endpoint, actually China and Hong Kong together are more or less the same size when it comes to where the money ultimately ends for payments out of the Philippines. So I thought this was an interesting detail to share. And we come back to that on how you can capitalize on this knowledge. Let's look a bit at trade. I have two slides on trade, specifically on letters of credit. This slide shows letters of credit in volume, right? The messages in volume, with Philippines as the exporter. What are the major counterparty countries? And how did this evolve? This is 2014 in the inner circle and 2015 in the outer circle. The numbers are quite stable in general. Top right, Korea is very important. South Korea, I mean, is very important. And that's, in fact, is not just for the Philippines. It's almost everywhere. It's very common with South Korea that letters of credit are used. Interestingly, at the bottom, you see China going from 8% to 5%. Meaning is not that there is less trade with China, I think. More likely, more and more of this information goes to open account. Well, I see that a number of people are making pictures, but later on you will be able to download the slides so you can analyze that in more. You can analyze it more at your leisure. So don't worry if you miss a number here or there. Huh? So regarding China, because most likely this is about going to open account more, you may think about using new services to offer which are useful in the context of open account, like the bank payment obligation instrument, which is specifically geared for the banks to be to play an important role in the world of open account. But so this was volume. Let's have a look at value. And at the left is Philippines as the exporter, at the right as the importer. And you see the countries and the share, relative share, all for last year. What I think from this, you may have heard about the MT798 messages. These are messages that SWIFT has developed and are being adopted at quite a large scale now for automation of trade-related messages between corporate and bank. So to apply for a letter of credit, for example, it's about guarantees and standbys to make amendments. Well, I do think if you are interested in those, well, if you focus on these countries where most of the value is regarding your letters of credit, this would probably be a good decision. So until now, I showed you, these are market trends. And we can show you more, we prepared some more data at the demo table, which is, you will be able to go there in the coffee break. So there is a bit more deep diving about these data. Now I want to, in this last brief slide, I just want to draw attention to everything that you saw are general market trends. But how are you doing? Well, with this tooling that Swift have, you can also see how you are doing. For example, you may think, well, my business is growing with 7%, so I'm doing well. But if the market in the Philippines is growing with 10%, then you're doing less well than average. The whole idea is that we can help you with our business intelligence tools to really define and benchmark a strategy. For example, I thought the initial two slides were quite interesting about where does the money end up, mainly in USD, and a lot of it ends up in China or in Hong Kong. Well, because of the rising importance of the RMB, you may think, well, it is worth also investing there to offer RMB services. And then you could use this kind of tooling to see how are we doing compared to the Philippines market. There are other things you can check, like what are on average our charges compared to the average in the market. You can check things like what is our percentage of confirmed letters of credit, etc. So the whole idea is that all this SWIFT data can be used for your own benchmarking to define and follow up on your strategy. And that is why I think, next to the general market trends, I think it's really interesting for you to do a brief visit to the BI table in the demo booth. So I hope you found this interesting. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Tom.